Go get Twixie. Twixie. Can I borrow you for a second, Twix? And I don't know if... Are you mad, Twixie? I don't know if you've ever met Twixie before, but this is my little dog, Twixie. And she is terrified of everything in the house and the world that makes a noise. Thunder, storms, everything like that. Let me put her down. So the video that I did a while back where I set my drums up in here and I was like, I'm going to do some drum covers, you know, name a song and all this crap. Well, she's terrified. I've played the drums in the house before and I just don't understand why she's just gotten to where she's just worse about being scared than she used to be. And I felt sorry for her. So I thought what I needed to do was buy an electric set of drums. So I ended up buying the Alesis Strike Pro Special Edition, their flagship electronic drum set. You know, it's got the mesh heads and everything. And excuse the mess in this video because I was not planning on shooting this video today. This is Saturday. And Z Sounds, they just decided they wanted to be a badass. And they shipped these things out. In like 2 days, I ordered them on Thursday and it was like not supposed to come until the middle of the week. And then Saturday, I get a notification that it's out for delivery. So I was like, surprise to me. So I wanted to start the video because I didn't want to like, this is not going to be an unboxing, okay? But I didn't want to like unbox them, you know, without capturing it in some sort of way because there's only one thing about these drums that I don't like. So I'm going to get this box open and we'll talk about that. All right, let's get this Tom out here. And let me show you guys what it is that I don't really care for. And honestly, I don't think there's another brand out there that could satisfy my needs for this type of stuff here. So, yeah. Here's the 8-inch Tom. Well built. Heavy. I like it. So any of you guys out there that's been around my channel for a while, you might notice that there's something about this drum that I do not like. I will give it to them. The sparkle finish is pretty cool, but my least favorite color on the planet is red. So my plan is before I even set these drums up at all, as I have the green chrome from the failed attempt of putting this on the Gold Wing. Maybe I can flash a photo up of what that looks like if I can find it. But this is green chrome. I'm going to fully disassemble all these drums before I even set them up. And I'm going to rewrap them in green. So I'm not going to bore you guys with that. Like, I'm not going to just like talk you guys through it. I'm probably just going to set up some time lapses or whatever. And so yeah, I'm just going to get started. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start pulling this drum apart. We're going to time lapse the whole thing. I got a rug that'll be here tomorrow, a new rug. And let's rewrap these things. It's probably going to be a week before you hear from me again. So here we go. We'll be right back. okay, YouTube, it's more than a week later. It's actually 2 or 3 weeks later. But anyway, that was a horrible disaster. I've never really filmed a drum cover before. I've always wanted to film one, and I think I went about that all wrong. I recorded the track first using my Scarlett 18i20 or whatever this thing is, into GarageBand, and I laid down the track, got a good recording, and then I tried to film the drum cover, and that was a horrible idea. If I do drum covers, I'm probably not going to like do it that way, because I've discovered that this DJI mic has a line in input, and I have discovered that I could just split out of this into this and go straight to my phone and get decent recordings, you know, something like this. It doesn't have like the bottom end. I can't really EQ it, if that makes sense. I may figure that out. I may could like do that when I want to like just quickly be able to like do quick little drum covers, hassle free. Just set up the phone on the tripod, plug the microphone in, and you know, get her done. But anyway, that's enough rambling about that. The drums come out awesome. I love how they come out. I spent a lot of time making sure that the wiring was nice and neat. I got me a monitor over here for when I want to, you know, play out loud. I got a Mackie. I don't really know the model number on that thing. I got that. I'm using my DW5000 pedals right now. I do not like double pedals, but, you know, it is what it is. I do want to get an extra bass drum in the future. I've been trying to find some of those on Facebook Marketplace and stuff like that, because I'd like to get, like, maybe a used one, because I don't really need, like, a new bass drum, and then maybe get some new pedals or whatever. I've got my iPad set up here on a pretty cool, I got a RAM mount system that it's working out great for holding my iPad, so I can do because this thing has where you can, like, I'm not really going to do a review on the drum set right now, but a couple of things that I have noticed that I'm not real happy with the hi-hat and how it performs, and that's like a huge thing on the internet. A lot of people are talking about, you know, their settings that I have not messed with any of the settings. This is bone stock. On that cover, I was using the, I was using the Birch Rock drum set for that. Just basic, not tinkering with any of the settings or anything. I did adjust the EQ over here when I was, you know, listening to my playback or whatever. So I'm not like super proud of the recording that I got from that or whatever. It was real easy to just put the Tom Sawyer track into GarageBand and then just play along with it. And then maybe I could turn Tom Sawyer down just a little bit, you know, to bring the drums up. So, you know, you could really tell that it was a drum cover because the drums were really loud. I said I don't want to get into doing a review, but I'm not happy with the rack system. The rack system kind of sucks. It's not very rigid at all. So yeah, I have the DW rack from, I still have my acoustic drums. Anybody out there that's hating on electric drums, you know, you need acoustic drums. I have a set of acoustic drums, but I have these because they're not very, I can speak over them. They're not very noisy. The cymbal slaps is kind of loud. They're not very loud, so I love that. The dogs are happy. Everybody's happy in the house. Everybody can do the things they want to do. And I can come in here, put my headphones on, beat the drums. But I do want to upgrade some things because the rack sucks. And I don't like a double pedal. I like a double bass. So anyway, enough about that. If you're not subscribed, what the hell are you doing? Why are you waiting? You've watched this whole video and you haven't subscribed yet. I don't know what kind of content you like to watch this long of a video and not subscribe yet. I don't know what your problem is. But anyway, see you guys in the next one.